All right, welcome to the Ravit Show. We are here at Data Plus AI Summit by Databricks, and look who I have with me, Raj, founder and CEO of Profesi. Raj, welcome to the Ravit Show. Such a pleasure to have you back on the Ravit Show. I know we spoke at Gartner and you had such amazing insights, and I've seen so much of transformation, like the real transformation from back then to now in just a few months, and all the amazing announcements that you all are making. I saw the session this morning as well, which was fantastic. Just for our audience, would you like to quickly introduce yourself, tell us more about data transformation, why is it important, just want to learn a little more about it, and I'm pretty sure the audience would be excited too.
Yes, thank you so much, Ravit. I really appreciate you having me on the show. Excited to be here again. So yeah, I'm Raj Bains. I'm the founder CEO of Profesi. We've been doing this for many years.
Right.
This has been a very exciting show. We built a data transformation co-pilot. We are all about productivity. As you look at the data platforms,
right,
you see Databricks. It is a very powerful platform. They do data processing. They had Spark. They added SQL. They added ingestion. They add more and more and more. And what we looked at it and say, wait, but what about the user? Right? And
right,
who's thinking about the user, making them productive? So Profesi is all about making the data users, the data engineers, the data analysts, the data scientists much, much more productive on the data platform like Databricks that you already have. So that's the core thing of the company is productivity. Can more people, not just the people
right,
who code, use the product, can they become really productive with it? Can they, you know, handle the data themselves? Because everybody wants to be able to transform data, do analytics, but you know, it's not going to work if you have 10 coders in the basement doing it. You want everybody to do it.
Yes,
doing it, yeah.
Exactly. Very interesting, and thanks for sharing those details. Obviously, Copilot has been talk of the town. I've been hearing so many attendees talking about the
yes,
Profesi Copilot, and obviously, everyone's kind of excited about it. I'm kind of curious to know, obviously, what should the Copilot for data look like? Do you have any analogy around that and that you would like to share
yeah,
with the audience?
I mean, the co-pilot for everybody is going to be different, right?
True.
So the co-pilot, if you're reading and writing English, ChatGPT is great.
Right.
And your question is great, right? Because if you look at GitHub, GitHub has a co-pilot. You write something in English, it's going to give you back a blob of code. If you're a coder, you're like, I love this. Let me understand the code, then modify the code.
Yeah.
You're a data analyst transforming data. A blob of code is no good for you. You're like, oh, I asked a question, I have a blob of code. Well, that's not the co-pilot for me. That is the coder's co-pilot.
Right, right.
So the data co-pilot has got to understand your data. It's got to understand your data ecosystem. If I am working with my data, my co-pilot has to understand that, and in the context of that, help me build my pipeline.
Right.
So it has to meet the data user at their skill set. You can't, chat interface is not the right interface, right? Visual drag and drop is what makes data users productive. You're like, okay, I want that. And then, you know, if you want to use chat to ask the co-pilot to generate something,
very
you can
important,
do that.
Yeah.
But what it's generate can't be text, it can't be code. It's got to be a visual pipeline so the user can understand it, modify it, do that last mile thing. Because co-pilot is not a pilot.
Right.
It's not going
exactly,
to do the whole work for you.
Exactly.
It's going to take you to that point where, you know, last 20%, 10% you do yourself,
yeah,
but then what it gives you back is should be an interface that you can actually use to do the last 10 to 20%. I think that is the key.
I like how you've explained it, and definitely it shouldn't be the coder's code for a co-pilot, right? It has
yeah,
to be where the co-pilot needs to understand data pretty well.
Yes.
And your architecture where you on what you're working on. And that's the game changer for the enterprise folks. I'm pretty sure about that.
No, it's pretty, yes, it is. And so one thing is that we had with co-pilots, we had the first generation,
right,
which is like GitHub co-pilot. Right, it doesn't have other technologies integrated. It's a thin wrapper on LLM. But now, for the data users, you need to have a lot more technologies. You need to have the visual drag and drop interface. You need to understand the data context, all of that.
Right.
And then as our enterprise customers use it, they're getting tremendous productivity out of it because we are writing half the pipelines and they're like, I love this. They go back home, they play with their dog. You know, that
right,
AI should do you know, make our lives better.
These are fantastic insights, and definitely if you know, for data engineers, that is one big pain point too, right?
Yes.
Where, okay, we're spending so much time building it, how can we automate things, how can a co-pilot actually make our job easier, right? So that's awesome. Also quickly wanting to learn a little about some examples that you could share about how this can impact organizations, how it can, you know, obviously, because I'm pretty sure at length you're working with so many enterprises, they're already using the Copilot too. How is it helping them?
Yeah, so there are different organizations have slightly different challenges. Some people are only about, you know, are where you have data engineers who just want to be more productive.
Right.
And they use the Copilot, and that's great. We have organizations like one of the largest pharma companies. They had the line of business users give requirements to the data platform team in Word.
Yep.
Then they write code for it. The code comes back. Then they say, oh, you missed this. I forgot about this. They go back and iterate. And it takes months.
Wow.
Right? Yeah. And data users like, well, I need my data today.
Yeah.
So what we did is we gave the Copilot in the hand of the line of business user. They can build it themselves with a lot of productivity, with Copilot doing half the work.
Yeah.
And so what they are able to do is now they build the pipelines themselves. All the back and forth is gone. They are able to do 10 times more work. They said we do generate 10x more, and they presented at the Gartner conference.
Nice. Wow.
And they're like, and they went on stage and said, we produce 10 times more data objects than we used to. The tables, the target tables. So they're like, that much more data is getting processed by the same team. So big changes. We have one of the biggest hyperscalers, a cloud player. They use us. There's a platform team. The platform team gives the Copilot to all the business users and say, use this. And then if they need something that's not there, we have plugins.
Yeah.
So you can say, oh, you need a component that reads this system, does that thing, and it's not there. Data platform team says, let me build one for you.
Yeah.
So we also enable the code people and enable them to be productive.
It's a game changer for sure. And thanks for sharing those details. It definitely helps in if, you know, obviously the enterprises out there are saving time, cost, and they're more impactful in the business.
Yes.
It is something which is what they would run after.
Yes, it's with generative AI,
yes,
more and more is being asked of the data teams, right? And it's not like they're getting more budget.
Yeah.
So what's happening is you have the same data platform team, they've been asked to do generative AI, and they're all busy with doing the day-to-day work, building pipelines for the business users. And with us, it's like, okay, here, you give it to the business users, say you build your own pipelines.
Right.
And that frees up the time for all those data engineers to go to deal with unstructured data, generative AI, real value add tasks, right?
Right.
So you need to do a lot more with less with generative AI.
Yes, exactly. That's so true. And so just because we are on this topic, you know, one of my friends works for a big enterprise.
Yes.
Spent like almost 25 years in enterprise, manages a team of more than 50 people.
Yes.
He had the same thing where he's like, we don't have a new budget for AI. We just have to cover the same budget that we have in data stack. We need to make sure how we replacing that budget with something, how we are automating.
Yes.
And how more productive we could be with AI, and that's the, you know, that's how we are implementing AI.
Yeah, and that's what AI is for, right? AI is there to make, and that's what Copilots are all about. It's like you have users who are already doing a task,
right?
With the data platform they already have, can I double their productivity? That's the thing.
Exactly.
You don't, they're doing the same task, it's very not disruptive at all. They have the same data platform, Copilot comes in, boom. You can do twice the work, right?
The discussion, so
it's amazing productivity gains for users.
True.
Yeah, and every manager is looking at say
every day.
Every manager, it is top of their mind.
True.
They are like, Copilots are here. Well, how is it going to change my team?
Yeah.
Do I still need the same number of users, or can I repurpose them for doing some more interesting stuff? That is what most of our users are talking about.
It's a game changer for sure. And thanks for sharing all those insights. One curious question. What's next? Because whenever I talk to you, you always have something innovative, something new that you build for the data community, the AI community, and you make their work easier.
Yes.
What's next that I can expect in the next 3 to 6 months, 1 year? I don't know. But what's next?
I think what's coming next. So we've worked... So one thing that we are working on, of course, there's generative AI. It's going to do more and more.
Yeah.
Right? It was doing more using metadata, it's going to start looking inside your data and say, looking at this column, hey, this is the transform you need to run. So there's going to be generative AI every month. You're going to see new use cases, new use case. Then we have people who are Alteryx users.
Yeah.
We are adding Alteryx import. So what they can say is, I have these 500 pipelines already in Alteryx, but I want the same experience on Databricks. It's like import.
That's it.
The pipelines will come into Alteryx. They'll get orchestrated, run inside your SQL, and you're onto a new platform. Like that, same interface. So that's where we are looking at it. We are saying, how can we enable the organizations to move very quickly to this AI environment and get those productivity gains? But with generative AI, with all of this, we have low code and interface and AI. So the Copilot for Airflow as well for orchestration, that's coming.
Nice.
Yeah, we have the first few customers using it. So we're covering orchestration, we're covering Spark, we're covering SQL, making everything fast in data. So a lot of coverage and a lot more generative AI.
Can't wait. This is super exciting. Thanks for sharing those details. So one last question for you is, if folks want to reach out to you, learn more about Profesi, where can they do it? Is LinkedIn a best place?
Oh, if you want to reach out to me, LinkedIn is the best place, but mostly you probably care about Profesi, so go to profesi.io,
yes.
Try out the product, and reach out to our team. We're happy to give you a demo, show you what it can do. It's amazing.
Thanks, Raj. Always such a pleasure chatting with you on the Ravit Show, and definitely looking forward to our next conversation with all the next innovations that you would come up with. Thank you.
That sounds great. Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone.